semester Animal Associations. In the previous podcast, we have already covered material on parasitism, which is a heterospecific association. That is to say, it is an association between two different species in which one is the beneficiary, which not only derives nutritional benefit, but it also obtains the benefit of sheltering either on or within the other associating species or the host. Parasites are further classified accordingly as facultative parasites, obligatory parasites, and as ectoparasites. Ectoparasites differ from micropredators like mosquitoes, sandflies, black flies, horseflies, or tsetse flies. This podcast is a treatment of literature and material, or a condensation of material, on other heterospecific associations like commensalism, mutualism, symbiosis, predation, paratenic associations, and also parental care. In passing, I would like to mention that cannibalism too is an animal association, but it is not a heterospecific association. Cannibalism, nevertheless, is common. It is far more common in nature than it was thought previously. In heterospecific animal associations involving direct or indirect nutritional relationships, one of the following situations is likely to prevail. Number one, symbiosis, which is the association between heterospecific individuals in which both the two associates derive benefit from one another, and one of the partners provide shelter to the other. For example, the protozoan Trychonympha, Mastigophora, these shelter within the gut of the termite, and they also benefit the termite host by helping it digest cellulose. The next example is that of Zooxanthella, an algae living within the body of Lithocercus, Radiolaria protozoa, which receives oxygen, carbon dioxide from the host, and in exchange it photosynthesizes carbohydrates not only for itself, but its carbohydrates which it synthesizes diffuse into the body of its protozoan host. Next, we come to the instance of commensalism. In this type of heterospecific association, one of the associates receives nutrition while the other is neither benefited nor significantly harmed. While one of the species provides shelter to the other. Examples include Entamoeba coli, which shelter within the human intestine. Here, man is not significantly harmed, neither is man benefited in any way, while the protozoan draws nourishment from the human intestine. Endolimax nana is another intestinal protozoan of man. It is a commensal, just like Entamoeba coli. My next podcast will be an elaboration on animal transport involving different animal species. That is to say, some animal species utilize another species as a mode of transport or a means of transport.